something, girl.
This week we've been talking about being outside the box. So I could stay right here inside the box and take this easy shot, but we're talking about outside the box. So I'm gonna step outside the box and take the hard shot. Today we are talking about give outside the box. We're talking about give of what God has given to us, our talents and abilities. See, if God would have been living in fear, I would have took the easy shot and not really used my talents and abilities that God has given me. But He gave us so many talents and so many abilities. And then we put that to what God gives us, we're able to achieve the awesome. So what I did, I step out, I took the long shot because I know God is right there with me, and I gave of my talents for God. I want you guys to join me here in just a little bit. I'm going to get my handy toolbox here, and we are going to come together and we're going to teach you all about what God has to give outside the box for us. Hey, and guess what? When we give outside the box, this is what happens.
Perfect, perfect.
Goody. I can't wait to pull. Oh boy. There's Mr. Tim. Hey, Mr. Tim.
Hey.
Hey, it's me, Stuart.
Hey, Stewie.
Listen, I think I outran my friends, but the pool, I'm here to go swimming and it says it's closed.
Yeah, pool is closed. It's not time.
It's not time, but the pool is closed. I gonna do?
That we don't have a lot to give to the Lord as small children. But the truth is, we have everything that God has poured inside of us that we can give back to Him. Let me give you an example. I have in my hand some very small, little tiny pieces of white flakes. This right here, this is going to represent my talent. But when I give my little bitty talent to God, what He pours in and what He adds to my talent, wow.
Pastor Lynn, can I help you?
Yes! Can you take what's inside that bucket and put it in my hands?
Yes.
Add it to me. Yes. That's awesome. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Get some more. Do you see that? Oh my goodness, that's awesome, thank you. When we take what we have and we give it to God, when God takes our talent, He makes beautiful things happen with it. We just have to be willing to give our talent, as small as it is, to God.
Well, I guess the pool's closed. Might as well go get me a slushy. I mean, the least I can do is a slushy and maybe a Frito pie. I'm so excited.
Hey, Stevie.
Hey, Mr. Tim, I just saw you up at the pool and the pool's closed and want to get me a slushy. Can I get a slushy?
Canteen is closed. It's not time.
Oh, it's closed. Canteen's closed too? The world must be coming to an end.
Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to our scripture verse today. Today, what we're going to do is we're going to practice it with our motions. So I'm going to do it one time, and then we're going to do it together. So the scripture is from Romans 12, 2. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Romans 12, 2. So now let's do it together. Do not conform unto the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Romans 12, 2. All right, you guys ready? We're going to do a scripture verse challenge. What I'm going to do is I am going to say the scripture verse and leave out a blank. And on the screen, you'll see the blank, okay? Then you guys are going to have to think about it. What word to go in there? And then we'll go over the answer. You guys ready? Let's get started. Do not conform to the pattern of this. What word to go in there? If you said world, great job. It goes, do not conform to the pattern of this world. Let's do another one. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be what goes in the blank? Transformed. Exactly. If you said transformed, you got it. Let's practice again. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your what you go in the blank? If you said mind, you've got it. Let's do it all together one more time. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Romans 12, 2. Thanks for joining us. Remember to keep practicing your scripture. Bye.
Wait, at least the lake, maybe this will be good. There's no pool. Canteen's closed. The lake, man, it's looking good. A little suspect. Dirty, but it's okay. Oh, hey, Mr. Tim, I just saw you at the pool and the canteen and the lake now. What kind of jump? Can I get one of them, the
life vest?
Life vest, yeah, and just take off?
Can I jump in the lake? Sorry, Stewie, the lake events are closed. It's just not time.
Lake events are closed. It's not time. It's getting too much. This is heavy. It's hot and it's heavy. Okay. Thanks, Mr. Tim.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop. His name is above. His name is above depression. His name is above loneliness. Oh, His name is above disease. His name is above cancer. His name is above every other name. He says, that is who we are.
Hey guys, over the last few days we've been talking about living outside the box. We have learned that we aren't supposed to be like the world, but we are called to be set apart and different. We've also learned that when we make the decision to be set apart and different, that God can use us. We can learn that He'll provide for us, and He'll give us victory outside the box. Today our main point is give outside the box. Everybody say that with me. Say give outside the box. Awesome job. We are going to talk about giving outside of the box today. Let's jump right into our Bible story and see what happens. So, we're going to read in John 6. Everybody say John 6, 2, 14. John 6, 2, 14. It says this, a huge crowd following Him wherever He went because they saw His miraculous signs as He healed the sick. Who? Jesus, of course, right? Then Jesus climbed a hill and sat down with His disciples around Him. It was nearly time for the Jewish Passover. Jesus saw a huge crowd of people around Him. They were coming to look for Him. He turning to Philip, He asked, "Where can we buy bread to feed all of these people?" He was testing Philip, for He already knew what He was going to do. Philip replied, "Even if we worked for months, we wouldn't have enough money to feed all of these people." And then Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, spoke up. He said, "There's a young boy here with 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good is that for this huge crowd?" "Tell everyone to sit down," Jesus said. So they all sat on the grassy slopes. The Bible tells us there was 5,000 men alone, not counting women and children. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks to God, and distributed them to the people. Afterwards, He did the same with the fish, and everyone ate as much as they wanted, until they were full. Then Jesus told His disciples, "Now gather all the leftovers, gather them up, so that nothing is wasted." So they picked up the pieces and filled 12 baskets with scraps left by the people who had eaten. When the people saw Him do the miraculous sign, they exclaimed, "Surely He is the prophet we have been expecting." Isn't that cool? Jesus did an awesome miracle. He took 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread, and He fed way over 5,000 people. I would love to have been there that day. I know you guys probably would have too, to see Him take that little bit and make so much. But the coolest part of this story to me is when we look at this, and this all happened because one boy decided to give. He decided to give outside the box. See, God wants us to be willing to give, to help others, and not just with our money, like we hear give all the time, but to give of different things, our talents, our skills, and all kind of things we have. We're going to talk about 2 ways today that God wants us to give. I want everybody to say, give! We're going to talk about 2 ways. So way number 1 we're going to talk about. I've got an awesome toolbox right here beside us, and my toolbox today is going to help us. Our toolbox is going to help us understand some talents and skills that we can use. So our first way is that God wants us to give of our talents and abilities He's blessed us with. See, our talents and abilities, we didn't make them on our own, But God gave us those, and He gave us those abilities for us to use for His kingdom. Our toolbox today is going to help us understand some things and understand some different ways that we can use our talents to give to God. See, 1 Peter 4:10 and 11, it says this. It says, God has given each of you a gift from His great variety of spiritual gifts. Use them well to serve one another. Do you have the gift of speaking? Then speak as though God Himself is speaking to you. Do you have the gift of helping others? Do it with all the strength and energy that God supplies. Then everything you do, let everything you do bring glory to God through Jesus Christ. All glory and power to Him. That Bible verse tells us that we all have a gift. God has given each one of us a variety of spiritual gifts for us to use. So way one, give of our talents and abilities. So we look at our box right here. I've got some things that we're going to look at. And the first one is a hammer. It's a hammer right here. And when you see this, you probably think of what? A builder, right? Some kind of builder, a craftsman, somebody that has a gift and the ability to building. This one, not my gift. I don't really do building well. Some of you guys do so awesome. But we look at this and say, how can God use this? How can God use this for me to use that for His kingdom? Well, let's think about it. How are churches made? Somebody has to build them, right? What about stuff that happens on the mission field? How do they build these churches for these people that are needy? Builders, right? What about the homeless? People need help for that, right? What about our awesome VBS sets that we have every year? Builders. See, builders can use things from the kingdom of God too. Not just speakers. Builders can do the same way. Let's look at somebody else. How about this right here? A calculator. Some of you guys might be awesome at math. Some of you guys might be like, oh, math. Pastor Chandler, I do not like math. Some of you guys might love math. See, math is one of those things where we can always use. But you say, how can I use my good skills, my number skills, to help in the kingdom of God? See, every church has a need for people that can help with finances. People that can help with balancing the budgets and help with dealing with the money that comes into the church. But also something else that people need help with money. See, when you're a banker or accountant or whatever you use for this talent, you have the ability to help people every day. And when you help people, you can show them the love of Jesus every day by helping them and bringing joy to people, a place where a lot of people really struggle. That's another way we can help, with our calculator. Let's look. Let's see what we want next. What about this? A first aid kit. Well, what does this make you think of? To me, it makes me think of nurses or doctors, right? How can you use this medical gifting as a way to work for the kingdom of God? Well, maybe you can use things. You can help people, right? These people are constantly putting others before themselves. We've seen it right now with everything that is going on, that these people are working on the front lines, putting themselves before others to help others. That's just like Jesus did, right? Jesus did that for us. He put us before Himself all the time. Also, these people that are dealing with doctors, nurses, a lot of them are scared. They're worried. Something's going on in their life. And most of the time, if you've ever been at a doctor or a nurse, a lot of people are worried and a lot of people are scared. You can be the one that can remind them that God will help us no matter what we're going through, that God is there for us and He'll never leave us. You might be the one that brings joy to somebody who is worried and scared in some kind of hospital. What else have we got in here we can find? What about a microphone? Man, a lot of guys want these guys, right? We want the mic. We want to grab the attention. Some of us are like, no, I don't want to be on stage. But some of us want to have the mic. Maybe you're called to be a singer. Maybe you're called to be a pastor. Maybe you're called to be a speaker or something of some sort where you have a microphone, right? Where you have the ability. I think it's important to remind us that if you have a microphone, how can I use this for the kingdom of God? It's simple, right? If you're using a mic, that means you're speaking to people. That means you have a large audience in front of you somewhere. There's people out there that are listening to you, or you wouldn't need this. We can remember when we are in front of those people, and if that's the gifting that God has given us, we can use that platform to exalt God. We can use that platform to give glory to God that He deserves in whatever position we're in. And our last thing, right here, you guys all should know about this, our Bible. Maybe your calling is different. Maybe your calling is to ministry. I don't think we have to answer how we can use that calling for God, but maybe that's your calling. Maybe He's calling you to be a worship leader one day. Maybe He's calling you to be a lead pastor. Or maybe He's calling you to youth or children's ministry. Whatever that caller is, maybe that calling is to missionary work, to travel outside of the country to people that are in need. But maybe He has a calling on your life to do that. See, guys, whatever our different skills and abilities are, God, we read that earlier in 1 Peter, that God has given us skills and abilities. Each one of us have those abilities, and God wants to take that and find a way for us to use that for the kingdom of God. So that's way number one. Way number one is using our talents and abilities for God. Way number two, God wants us to give others the chance to receive the same gift of salvation that we have received. See, God gave us this gift. And if you've accepted Jesus in your life, you have the greatest gift of all. But now our job is to, in return, what are we supposed to do? Tell people about Jesus. Give them that same gift. What are we saying? Give outside the box, right? We're talking about giving outside the box. And what more could you give to somebody than giving them the gift of salvation? Now we understand we can't do that. We can't save anybody. But when we tell them about Jesus, we have the opportunity to give them the gift of salvation. How cool is that? We read Matthew 28:19-20. You've probably heard it called the Great Commission. It says, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you to the very end." God has called each one of us to make disciples of the nation. That means to go out and tell people about Jesus, to reach the whole nations. Now, I know you might look at me and say, "Pastor Chandler, I'm just a kid. How am I supposed to tell the whole nations, all the nations about Jesus?" Well, I got something, a cool object lesson that we want to look at that can help us remember this, help us understand how little old us can tell the nations about Jesus. So I want you guys to follow me right over here. We're going to look at some object lessons right here. We've got some balls right here and some cups, and they're going to help us learn how God helps us reach the gospel to the nations. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to take these cups. We're going to lay them down just like this. And this right here is going to represent our friend. Our friend that we need to tell about Jesus. Somebody that we know that needs to know about Jesus. See, right here is going to be our saved. People that know Jesus, that have a chance to accept Jesus as their Savior. And this person right here is representing somebody that needs to know Jesus. So we're going to put it right here. We're going to tell them about Jesus. This person's going to tell them about Jesus. And then this person's going to tell them about Jesus. We've told them about Jesus. So now that you know what they become? They become saved. So this is our saved spot right here. These are people that know Jesus. So they went straight through there, and now they're saved. But here's so cool, we keep doing this. We have another friend right here that needs to know about Jesus, and we tell them about it. We take time, and we read our Bible. We pray for them, and we tell them about Jesus. And this person gets right there. We talk to them, and this person tells them about Jesus. And guess what happens when we tell them about Jesus? Now they're both there. Now two people know about Jesus. And that's so cool how the gospel message works. But then we have an opportunity to have another friend. And we talk to him, and this person tells him about Jesus, and this person tells him about Jesus. You know what's so cool? They come into the kingdom of God with us. Now we have three. We have three friends that are now saved and that know Jesus, which is so cool. But here's the coolest part. And here's how we reach the gospel to the nations. We can't do it by ourselves. We understand that. So when we have no other friends, when we've done our job to tell others about Jesus, what happens is those people tell others about Jesus. And you notice there's nothing even there this time. But other people are telling about Jesus. And other people are telling their friends about Jesus. So those three people that we had that knew about Jesus, you know what happens to them? When we show up, now four friends know about Jesus. They become four people without us even telling anybody else because they spread the gospel to other people. See, that's how it works in the kingdom of God. When we tell people, and then they tell people, and then they tell other people, we have a chance to reach the nations together. We can reach the nations together as one team for Jesus. All right, guys, now we're going to reach our closing. But I want you guys to remember our two ways. There's two ways that God calls us to give outside of the box. In two ways. And our first way was giving of our talents and abilities. We read a passage that understood that God gave each one of us a gift, a talent, and abilities for us to use. I want to encourage you guys that God wants us to use those abilities for Him. And two, the second way, God wants us to give others the same chance to receive salvation, the same gift that He gave us. He wants us to give others that same gift of salvation. So in closing, guys, I'm going to pray for you guys. I'm going to pray for two things. I'm going to pray for your talents and your abilities and your giftings that God has given you, that you can find your purpose and your plan that God has for every one of us. And then two, I'm going to pray for those people that deal with fear of telling others. I'm going to pray that you'll find the people that God wants you to tell about Jesus, that those conversations come easy in your life. But guys, I want you to focus in with me and not play with our neighbor right now and not be distracted by different things, but I want you to pray with me. See, because my prayers are great as a pastor, but they're no more powerful than yours. Your prayers are just the same. So I want you to pray. Ask for God to show you the talents and abilities that He's given you. The talents that He's given you, ask Him to show you, God, what is the purpose? What is the plan that you have for me? And God, show me those people that you want me to share the gospel with. So pray with me. And Lord Jesus, we come to you. God, we just thank you for who you are. God, we just thank you for what you did for us, for dying for each and every one of us, for giving us the ability to receive salvation for what you did. And God, we thank you for your gifts that you've given us, the talents and skills that you've given every one of us to use, God. And God, we pray right now, God, that you would be with us and that you would show us what you've given us for. Those gifts you've given us, God, that you would show us the purpose, God. We understand that even no matter what our skill is, no matter what our abilities are, that we are to bring glory to you. That we are to use those skills to bring glory to your kingdom, to build your kingdom together. And God, show us the purpose for our lives. Show us the plans that you have for our talents and our abilities and how we can use those abilities to bring glory to you. And God, we pray right now that you would open doors for us to tell people about Jesus, that we could give outside the box, that we could give people the ultimate gift, which is salvation, that we could have the opportunity to give people the chance to receive you as their Savior. Make those conversations easy in our lives. Show us, God, as we pray, as we seek you, God, that we show us who those people are that we need to talk to about Jesus. And we'll thank you for everything you do for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Guys, I want you to remember those two ways. And let's remember to give outside the box. Give of your talents. Give of your abilities for the kingdom of God. And give of that salvation that He gave us. Give it to others who need that in your life. Thanks, guys. Okay, so what we have right over here, you have a piece of paper with nine marks on there. You can also do with a dry erase board if you want to. But right over here, for our leaders, they are pondering this right over here, and Stewie already knows what he's going to do. All right, so this is what you're going to do. You have your piece of paper. Now, what you're doing is this. Once you have your marker in hand, you have to connect all nine dots using only four lines. Now, again, you have to connect all nine dots only using four lines, and once your pen hits the paper, it can't get up, okay? So you can't get on there and go, okay? It's gotta be four straight lines, and all of the dots have to be connected. So again, this is about giving outside the box, thinking outside the box, being creative in what you wanna do, okay? As you can tell, that this creative crew is actually quiet, so they're really pondering on this right over here, okay? Are we ready? On your mark, again, remember, four, everybody hold your fingers up, say four lines.
Four lines.
Say four lines.
Four lines.
Stewie, how many lines?
Four lines.
Four lines. Okay, one more time, everybody say four lines.
Four lines.
All right, you guys ready? On your mark, get set, go. Okay, now if you saw the way Stewie did it, if you went like this and you went back, is that two lines?
That is.
That's two lines. Okay, so flip it back over. Here we go. Ready?
That's still one big line, Mr. J.
I know, but how many times did you go over it, though?
I stood on the same line. I didn't rewrite a new line.
Thank you, Stewie. All right, very good. Okay, ready? Set, go.
That's wrong, Mr. Mine is also wrong. I missed one.
Okay, here's the way to do it.
Probably my way, the one I did earlier. You went outside the line. That's like
give outside the box. I never said you had to stay inside of the nine dots. Go outside. Everybody go, oh!
Oh!
Outside the box, baby. So a lot of times what we need to do is when we're living outside the box, we gotta think on our feet. So this game is called 10 points. What you're gonna do is you're gonna make a circle and you're gonna face out. The leader's gonna have a tennis ball. He or she, they're going to take the ball and they're going to bounce it. Right before they bounce it, they're going to say a point. Okay? 2, 3, 4, 5. The first person that catches the ball and gets to 10 wins. If you drop the ball, you lose the points. Okay? We got this. We ready? I need everybody to behave on this one. Okay? All right. Here we go. Ready? Set. Okay. No. Okay, we got this. All right, here we go. Come on, Stewie. Here we go. Ready? One. Okay, here we go. Ready? Two. Okay, Stewie, here, let me have the ball. Let me have the ball.
Well, I caught it.
No, you did. But again, what are we supposed to be doing? We're supposed to be
catching it,
yes, but we're supposed to be facing out.
Of the box.
Okay, out of the box, yes. All right, so ready? Here we go. Ready? Three.
I got it again.
Okay, Stewie, come here. Come here. Come here, come here. We have the ball. Come here. Come here. Listen. Come here. We talked about this, okay? Do you want to stay in the game?
Yes.
You want to behave the right way?
Uh-huh.
Okay, don't act like Pastor Chandler, okay? I need you to pay attention, okay?
But I was turning.
No, listen. You turn around. Okay. You're facing away from the ball.
Okay.
When I call the points, then you catch it, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Miss LaRonda, you're watching him, okay? You're watching him. All right, here we go. Ready? Stewie, turn around.
Watching me.
Okay. Ready? Three. Okay, three points for Matthew. All right, here we go. Ready? Two. Two for Chandler.
I can't catch it!
Three. Okay, that's three for Chandler. Okay, so Chandler's got five. Two. So that's two for Matthew. Okay. Ready?
Go turn around, Chandler.
Three. Okay. Three for Chandler. Okay. You're at seven?
Eight.
Oh, okay. Three. Okay. So you keep playing all the way to 10 till somebody wins, and you can do it different ways like this one. That's the end of the game.
I mean, this time, I hope Mr. Tim's not mad at me. I got pretty upset with the last paddle boats. Maybe this one. Just take a quick shower and jump on the Tommy.
Hey, Stewie.
Tim. I was going to come and my last hope was the Tommy Tsunami, and it looks like you're locking it, Mr. Tim. Why
yeah.
Is there no slide?
It's still closed. It's not time. But Saturday, August the 1st, come back and bring your friends, Kids Day, families with them. It's going to be a blast. Everything will be open, Stewie. Everything.
Everything
will be open.
August 1st!
Invite everybody, you know, all the kids' friends.
But it's so far away. What am I going to do? Mr. Tim, I can take it.
Why is there no slide? August 1st?